I will give a very brief note on what the struggle is. But before that, I would like to take an opportunity on behalf of JNU Students Union to actually thank, and it's a privilege that JNU is having these two icons today, Comrade Ravi Kumar and Comrade Tirunavalavan today. And in short note, I will really speak short, but then before that, to the students of JNU, I would like to tell that Comrade Tirunavalavan here, these people have been fighting and have been with the Dalit movement in Tamil Nadu. And on JNU, on behalf of JNUSU, we extend immense solidarity and support to these fighting icons who have been fighting in the forefront of the Dalit movement in Tamil Nadu, and extend all our solidarity with the Dalit movement going. And specifically talking about how the RSS and BJP functions, we need to know how Comrade Tirunavalavan have been targeted continuously on by maligning lies, the BJP and RSS functions, that personally targeting him, that he has hurt, and false claims of hurting Hindu sentiments and what not. And this is a shameful way how that the agenda of the BJP and RSS is to malign and to target the Dalit communities of our country. And this is not in isolation. This is exactly happening also in our university today when the reservations are being scuttled. We can see what is the whole agenda. It's to keep out the marginalized section out from the university spaces, from the educational spaces. And we need to remember that today when we're talking about the hostel manual, we are forgetting about majorly specificing about the SCST OBC reservations and the PWD reservation. And when we should highlight that how JNU is not maybe the one of the best universities, but has been a university which has been trying through its deprivation points and through its model to have education for all. And this is what the RSS and the BJP is fearing, the education for all model. It is fearing that the marginalized sections will get education tomorrow and they will be empowered and they will question, the minority sections will question. And to brief about that, first of all, I would really like to thank you from the JNU Students Union for coming here and extending solidarity. And with this, because we had a meeting with the MHRD, I'll just brief on that, because other struggles, we all have been part each other in a united way. I don't need to go in back. But today what happened in MHRD was we went for the meeting where three-member high-power committee was there. And the three demands that JNUSU told in front of students, we had kept it clear that this table in front of the committee is not for negotiation. We are clearly coming out with the agenda that our IHA meeting, which took place on 28th of October, has to be withdrawn. All the recommendations has to be withdrawn immediately. And along with that, all proctorial inquiries sent during this time, whether within the universities, and all cases been taken up by the university on students being targeted outside and FIR been filed, should be withdrawn. And the Home Minister should be made accountable why such brutal lathi charge has been happened on the students on the streets of Delhi when JNU students were peacefully marching for their right of education against fee hike. Thirdly, we have told that if the MHRD, which themselves have appointed the Vice Chancellor, is failing to have a dialogue with the Vice Chancellor, because we, through media reports, have come to know that the Vice Chancellor has denied even to appear before the committee. If the MHRD is failing to even convince the Vice Chancellor to come for a dialogue, then the MHRD should take a step further and remove this Vice Chancellor from the post of the Vice Chancellor of the Jawaharlal Nehru University. I will not extend much, but I would really thank that they have been called, and I think so a memorandum will be given. And I would request on behalf of JNU Students Union that today the question is not only about JNU, it's about IIT and all the fee hike that is happening and the way the public education model is being tried to be destroyed. If that can be taken up in the parliament, it will be really grateful on behalf of the JNU students. Thank you.